Okay, in this video tutorial we're going to use a completely different method to recover our device. We're going to use a method without a PC. We also have other methods that require a PC, which we've listed in the video description and in the first pinned comment. But in this video tutorial, we're going to use a method without a PC. What are we going to do first? First of all, we're going to connect to a Wi-Fi network before starting the recovery process. What we did was reset our device because it had a screen lock that we had forgotten. We formatted it, and after formatting, it looked like this. Now, what are we going to do? We're going to make the following configurations. We're going to connect to the Wi-Fi network before starting the recovery process. Previously, we could access it this way, as per policy. For privacy, we used to be able to access it directly from here. But this function is no longer working. This method doesn't work because these devices have been updated. They're completely up to date. We're going to do the following. We'll go to the network settings. Go to the Wi-Fi network and connect. We'll tap here to connect, and once we're connected, we'll navigate through our device so you can see that it's completely locked because it has a screen lock and the Gmail account is forgotten. Previously, we could go here to add a new network, and from here we could click and access the device. The option to allow it would appear here, but this function is no longer working. Nor are these methods, because the devices have been updated. So what we're going to do is navigate through the settings until we reach the locked account. Many people write to us saying that our methods don't work for them. I always say that if they don't work, it's because you didn't watch the step-by-step video tutorial and you didn't follow the instructions exactly as we explain in this video tutorial. I know the video tutorial is a little long, but if you follow it step-by-step, you'll find a solution and be able to recover your device, since it also has this screen lock and a forgotten Gmail account. As we can see, we're back where it all started, since our device had this lock and what we did was reset it. We formatted it. We were left with the same screen lock again. And finally, we were also left with the Google account. Here we can see that we also had that Google account. For those who still know the email, you can enter the email. Click Next, and then add a password. When you add the password, it will give you access to the device. And that way you won't be able to watch the video tutorial to the end. Another option, if you don't know the email, is if you added a phone number to the email. That would be the second alternative. Enter the phone number. Click Next, and then it will send a recovery code to your device. You will receive a code that we will enter. After entering it, it will give us access to recover our phone. That said, it might not give you any of those options, or if you don't know how, I recommend that you watch the video tutorial step by step to the end. We also have other completely different methods in the video description and in the first pinned comment. PC method and no PC method. We are going to click here, forget Gmail. We click on write anything. We click on next again and we're going to do this step for about 30 seconds. We're going to do this same step for 30 seconds. Then what are we going to do? We're going to do the following. When we finish those 30 seconds, we're going to use the following to be able to access our device. We're going to use, well, I'll tell you what we're going to do here. Those 30 seconds have passed. Now, what we're going to do is use an OTG adapter. This is to be able to access the device. We're going to use a PC keyboard, wheel. Use a PC keyboard. Then we're going to connect the device here. We're going to insert a SIM card with a PIN code. We're going to insert a locked SIM card with a PIN code, and we'll be able to access the device with this. Now that it's locked, we're going to use emergency calling. We dial the emergency number according to your country. You dial it. Press the enter key here, and when Google Maps appears, you're going to click on it. We've already dialed the emergency number according to your country, and now when Google Maps appears, we're going to press enter here. We're going to do this until we get access. Here you can see that we've already been given access. Now, what are we going to do? We're going to remove everything. We're going to do the following. We're going to remove the locked SIM card with that PIN code. After we remove the locked SIM card with the PIN code, let's enter, we go down and up, it should look like this. Now wait for it to focus. Now being here, we're going to click here on skip. After we click on skip, we're going to click here anywhere. We're going to click here now on share, we're going to select message. New message, any number. We select it, we delete all this. We're going to delete everything. Now we're going to write www.youtube.com. We're going to click here. In most cases, clicking here several times means YouTube isn't working anymore. If we see that this option isn't working, I'm going to give you the alternative that you can access. You're going to click here on this URL that appears here, and it will give you access. It will give you access. Then you're going to click here, you're going to click the little circle, you're going to click settings. Here in settings, you're going to click this option. If YouTube shows as outdated, then what you're going to do is format the phone and come back again. The second time it will give you access. You're going to click here on accessibility. Enable it here, enable this first option, then the second option. Then these blue letters that say settings, then this menu will appear. This is the second to last one, and you're going to enable the accessibility menu. It's already enabled. We go back. We go back, back. Back, and back again. We click back, just one click so we don't exit. Now we click the little circle here, we click on settings. We click here on notifications. We activate notifications, we go back, we enter again, they're activated. Now we click here on location, we click OK. We click on accessibility settings, we enable this menu. We go back, we click on Google location settings. Then here we're going to click here where it says all. Now you're going to click on more system. Here you'll find Google services. You're going to disable them, disable them. Once they're completely disabled, what we're going to do now is restart our device. Now, once our device has completely restarted, we're going to wait to then complete the recovery process. That's why we always it's recommended to watch the step-by-step video tutorial so you don't miss any details and can fix your device. The first thing we did was reset our phone, and then we were left with that screen lock. But if you follow the steps exactly as shown on the screen, just like we're doing, you'll be able to recover your device quickly and easily. Now, what we're going to do? Well, I'm also going to explain that we have other completely different methods in the video description and in the first pinned comment. For those people who haven't been able to solve this problem yet, go to that description and you can fix it and recover your device. Now, what we're going to do is click here. We're going to click next, now it will take us to this section. Here we'll see the account, the Wii Fi network option will appear. What we're going to do is deactivate the network and we're going to reactivate it. We turn off the Wi-Fi and leave it activated. Now we're going to wait for the Wi-Fi network to drop. I've already deactivated it, I'm going to wait for the network to drop. So we can start the process and recover our device easily and quickly. Let's wait, it seems our device is locked here. It seems to be locked. I'm going to activate the switch here because it's locked here. This is normal for this to happen. Now I'm going to draw a backwards L here. Now I've left that network, now we're going to get here where the Wi-Fi network is. Click forward here, now we go back and return here. I'm going to turn the network off again and turn it back on. We turn it off, we turn it on now. Now we're going to get back to where the Wii network is. Why did I do this? Because it's going to let us get there, we'll leave it here, we'll wait for it to load again. Because if I don't stop it, it won't appear with these new updates. These devices have been updated and security has improved. Now we'll wait for the Wi-Fi network to load. It's loading now. Wait until it shows connected without internet. Here, it says internet. We'll wait for it to connect properly. Wait a few seconds. Okay, I changed the network, I set it to 5G. Let's click here on accessibility. Let's wait for it to open. Let's wait for a little camera to appear up here. Let's see if that little camera appears. Let's click here on these letters to see if it lets us. We click again, we click here, and it still doesn't work. It seems that the little camera icon that was showing up here before isn't appearing anymore. Well, don't worry, if that little camera icon isn't showing up, then what we're going to do is go back in. We're going to enter the locked SIM card with that PIN code. We're going to go back in since we have access from here. So what we're going to do here is remove the SIM card. We're just going to remove it. We'll pull down the notifications. We're going to click here on the day, the month, the week. We're going to click here on deny. We'll go to settings. We'll go to the three dots. We'll go here to the second option that appears, share. Here we're going to select Gmail. We'll go here to skip. We'll click here to enable. We'll skip it. We'll go back. We'll click here. Now, for the second time, we're going to turn off the Wi-Fi network. We're going to turn it off, we'll turn it back on. Now we'll go to, next, we'll go here to, skip. We'll go to, don't skip, right here in the center so that it takes us here to Google. This is still, it doesn't end there, since we still have some errors. I'm going to explain how you can correct these errors on this device. To correct these errors, I always recommend watching the step-by-step video tutorial. As we can see, we've already reached the home screen. Now that we're here at home, we're going to do the following. We're going to go to settings. Then here in settings, go to about phone and tap on reset. You're going to reset all those settings.